2015, Chris Pratt breathed new life into the old story of Jurassic World, and now another sequel. And we also get to follow the personal journey and legal legacy of U.S. Supreme Court Justice Ruth Bader Ginsburg. We have Michael Cook here to tell us a little bit more about these films.
Yes. Let's talk about Jurassic World Fallen Kingdom. This is the fifth in the Jurassic Park World canon, as it were. Here, Chris Pratt and Bryce Dallas Howard are back. This film starts about 3 years after the big tragedy at the Jurassic World Park. What the basic plot line is that where the dinosaurs is at Jurassic World, there is a volcano. And if this, there you see the volcano, obviously. And if these dinosaurs are not taken off the island, then they will all perish. And there's a debate at the beginning of, should we let nature take its course and let them perish, or should we take them off the island? Well, Bryce Dallas Howard's character goes back to the island. She's sent there by one of the founders of Jurassic World, played by James Cromwell, who has a massive mansion in Northern California, which will become important later in the film. And they then take the dinosaurs off. Look, I'm not giving anything away. You can see from the trailers, the final trailers, there's a bit of a double cross, and there's people who want to take these dinosaurs and sell them off on the market, sort of weaponize them for militaristic use. You know, a lot of chase scenes in this mansion at the end. The CGI is incredible, of course. You really feel like these dinosaurs exist. Mm-hmm. The problem with this film is that it has no heart and no real interesting story or characters. Even though you like Chris Pratt in the first one and Bryce Dallas Howard, here they're giving nothing to do except just chase after dinosaurs.
There's no emotional connection.
There's not very any really funny moments. Mm-hmm. It just doesn't have the heart. But again, the dinosaur, the CGI was all impressive. I give it a 7 out of 10, just because that part of it was well done. But unfortunately, of the five films in the Jurassic World Park series, this is my least favorite of them all. Mm-hmm. So, unfortunate. You know, if you like those, it might be good to see in terms of the dinosaurs chasing people. The next movie to talk about is called RBG. This is a documentary about Ruth Bader Ginsburg. She is a Supreme Court justice. There you see her. She is 85 years old. This tells a story of her life and how she became an attorney at a time when women attorneys were a very rarity, and the struggles that she went to in her career, and also how she fought to get more women involved in the law and other professions by court cases and just fighting tooth and nail. Also, it's fascinating about the story. It's also a lovely love story between her and her husband Marty, who met when they were 18, 17, right around that age, and spent a lifetime together. He passed away in 2010, unfortunately. It's also fascinating because later on in life, in the past 7, 8 years, she got the nickname RBG, the notorious RBG. Yeah. The millennials have given her that name, and it sort of talks about how she's become an icon. So this is just a fascinating movie. It's also interesting, you know, just to recall the struggles that women went through in the 40s, 50s, and 60s, and 70s, and even today. And Ruth Bader Ginsburg was on the forefront of fighting for these rights. So just a fascinating documentary that I truly loved. I highly recommend it. It's only playing at Riverdale. I give it a 9 out of 10.
Only at Riverdale.
Only Riverdale.
Okay.
So if you can either see a Jurassic World or a nice documentary, you got two choices this weekend.
7 or 9.
Exactly.
You decide.
Exactly.
All right. Thanks so much, Michael.
Thank
we'll
you.
See you next Friday. We'll have more Good Day after the break. Stay with us.